Hello, myself Sanjay Gaikwad. I am working as a head of the Department of Physics, Mahatma Phule AC College, Panvel, District Raigad. Here in the unit number 1 of the SYBEC syllabus of paper number 3, that is Applied Physics, unit number 1 is Acoustics, Laser and Fiber Optics. Actually, this syllabus is changed. In FYBEC, the laser and fiber optics are shifted from this SYBEC to FYBEC now in semester 2. Okay. Now we want to discuss in present lecture regarding unit number 1 and the syllabus of that unit number 1. Okay. Paper number 3, Applied Physics of SYBEC, and unit number 1 is the Acoustics, Laser and Fiber Optics. See, this front or the this photograph shows that the actual application of the physics, like by the acoustics, by the laser and fiber optics. See here the arrangement of the auditorium room or the seminar room, you can say that the arrangement shows that to distribute the sound pleasant or audible to the audience, it should be pleasant, sound should be pleasant or equally intense, or it will be hear audience equal sound at every corner, so that we can arrange the auditorium hall or the seminar hall, you can say that the recording rooms, like that the arrangement should be like this one, not like this. See, this is the equal height when we are seated at the classroom. If the hall is very big, then it is observed that the sound should be direct path, can reflect from the floor as well as from the ceiling. The first student can listen carefully or it can be get the audible sound, but as compared to that at the last student, it is quite possible to listen. Okay, means if we are arranged this type of arrangement of the class auditorium room, then we are unable to reach up to the last person. Sometimes sound should be not pleasant due to the reflection of the sound and the path of the sound. It shows that it should be like this in front, first figure and second photograph. It will be observed that when the arrangement is like this, then the sound should be pleasant and equally distributed in the hall, and everyone can listen carefully. And therefore, the acoustic of building or acoustic of the auditorium is very important, and the point of view of that we will discuss this topic. Additionally, that there is another chapter is the laser. Already we know that the laser is the one of the discovery, or we can say that the laser is based on the principle of the Einstein, that is the stimulated emission radiation. Already a laser has the long form as a light amplification by stimulated emission of radiation. Light amplification by stimulated emission of radiation. Okay, and the last one is optical fiber optics, or sometimes optical fiber, like that same word is there. See, these are the applications: cleaning, welding, cutting. Addition to that, there the in medical field, that is the dentistry, medical, 3D printing, electronics. There are a lot of applications are there for the laser. Laser has a wide application in current industrialization. Second thing, addition to that, there is a fiber optics which is based on the principle of total internal reflection phenomena, and on the basis of that, it is observed that optical fiber has the wide application in the lab, in the fabrication of chips, in the fabrication of the or medical diagnosis, or chemical sensing, temperature sensing, environment monitoring, pressure sensing, biomolecular sensing, in the sensor, or you can say that the optical fiber has the wide application not only in the communication system, additionally that in the medical field, in the research field, in the laboratory purpose, widely use the optical fiber. Okay, we will discuss one by one in this unit number 1, acoustics of a building, second laser and fiber optics. Okay, this is the syllabus. See, unit number 1 has the 15 lecture syllabus, and in which we have the acoustic of building, one first chapter, second is the laser, third is the fiber optics. So here you can see that RK, SP, like that. These are the references, like modern physics, SP means modern physics concept of application, by the written by the Sanjeev Puri and publication in Narosa publication. And second one is the RK, the properties of matter and acoustics, that is R Murugesan and Shiv Prasad, the Yaschan publication. Both our books are very useful and very good. And you can see that in the properties of matter and acoustic, the Murugesan writing is very good. Means the publication, books publication from the Yaschan are very good one. Easy to understand. They have given the very good derivations, everything. Okay. So generally we can refer the books of the Yaschan publication, which will be helpful. There are the various publications. Narosa publication is also very good one. It has also good liquid language available in the Narosa publication also. Now we go through this syllabus, that is acoustic of building. In this topic we discuss the first of all the study of the propagation generation of the sound. Okay, generally propagation, reflection, or you can say the study of the sound. Okay, there is a reverberation, another phenomena like that. There is a Sabine's formula, one of the W.C. Sabine is one of the scientists which study the more about the propagation of the sound, propagation generation of the sound. And there is one formula which can be given by the Sabine's formula. The derivation is very long one, but in our syllabus only we have the formula. Okay, so we are just discussing on the formula only. After that, absorption coefficient, acoustic of buildings, factors affecting on the acoustic of building, sound distribution in auditorium. These are the only articles of the syllabus included in our S5BSC. Additionally, that in laser, generally in introduction, we are study about the absorption, emission, transition between the atomic states, then principle of laser, that is the stimulated emission of radiation, properties of laser, that is the coherence, minimum divergence, high intensity and power, and monochromaticity. These are the properties of the laser. Additionally, that there is spatial coherence length, directionality, intensity. And we have in the syllabus helium neon laser, application of laser, and as a holography. Generally in the new syllabus included in the FIBAC in the semester second, that is laser, the addition of the syllabus is that in including the with helium neon laser, there is a ruby laser is included in the syllabus. Okay. Next, in fiber optics, the light propagation through the fiber, fiber geometry, internal reflection, numerical aperture is a very important thing. It gives the property of the laser, or you can say the ability of the fiber to gather the light, okay, or signal. Step index and gradient index fiber is the types of the optical fiber on the basis of index, that is the refractive index of the core. And second thing, there is another type is there, that is the single mode and multi mode gradient index fiber. And I addition that application of the optical fiber is the part of the syllabus. You should refer the reference book. Reference books are the very important when we are going to the deep knowledge of the subject. Otherwise, textbook also available, like said publication. Sometimes textbook of universities are also available in some universities. Okay, according to need, they have provided that. Chapter 1, acoustic of building. In this chapter, we will discuss on the reverberation. What is the reverberation? Second thing, explanation of Sabine's formula, importance of Sabine's formula, absorption coefficient, acoustics of building, factors affecting acoustic of buildings, sound distribution in auditorium. Introduction. Generally, in the first chapter, we want to study about the first of all definition of the acoustic of building. And it is generally study about the control of sound in buildings, cinema halls, auditorium, and the main part is the sound. Okay, the purpose to create the condition that everyone should be hear the sound comfortably. The definition of the acoustic of building is that a branch of physics that deals with the process of generation, reception and propagation of sound is called acoustics. A branch of physics that deals with the process of generation, reception and propagation of sound. First, generate the sound. Second, Reception means receive the sound, and third, the propagation of sound. These three parts are most important in the acoustics of building or acoustics. The branch of physics deals with the study of the planning, designing, and construction of the hall, auditorium, room to provide the best audible sound to every audience is called as the acoustic of building. See, in the acoustics, we study about the only sound, that is generation, reception, and propagation of sound. While in the acoustic of building, we planning or design or the construct the hall or auditorium hall, seminar hall. You can say they are the in case that the theaters, okay, or cinema halls like that. We want to plan or we want to construct this hall in such a way that to provide the best audible sound to the every audience is called as the acoustic of building. Okay, means we are planning the construction, designing the hall in such a way that every audience should listen the sound comfortably, or it should be good, pleasant. What are the essential features about the good acoustics? Means how we can say that there is a good acoustic or acoustic of building is there. So Professor W.C. Sabine scientifically tackled the problem in speech and music in a hall, and he gave the some essential features about the good acoustics. What are that? First, sound heard in an auditorium or the hall must be sufficiently loud to every part of the hall. Means generally, sometimes when we are teaching or when we are talking, we are sufficiently audible to the first 2 to 3 rows in the hall, and at last our sound is quite very low, so they are not able to listen there. Therefore, in auditorium hall, what happens? Generally, sound is not pleasant, or we can say that sufficiently not reach up to the every part of the hall. This is the very important. Sound should be reach up to the every part of the hall sufficiently, or you can say the equally or equal intense. Second thing, there should not be echo. Echo should be absent. Echo means you know that the repetition of the sound is there sometimes when the sees the sound by the speaker. Generally, echoes are very few times it is observed. Otherwise, if the receivers are there or the wall is made up of the windows, or sometimes we can say that some reflection should be minimized, in that case it is reduced. Therefore, there should not be echo, is very important. Otherwise, when the sound is reflected, we can listen repeatability, and it creates the echo. Generally, quantity of the speech of music must remain the same always. Means when we are going to speak, then our speech should be, our music should be remain same. Generally, what happens, sometimes sound goes to be declined, sometimes we can get the more intense, sometimes decline. Just like when we are when the air is flowing in the surrounding, the sound should be increased, sound should be decreased. This should be not there. Second thing, there should not be overlapping of successive syllables for the sake of clarity. Generally, what happened due to the echo type, the original sound and earlier sound mixed together, means syllables are successively overlapping, and therefore we are confused to listen, or there is no clarity in the sound. So the overlapping of the successive syllables should be avoided. Second thing, reverberation should be quite proper. Reverberation means what? There is the what happened, repeatability or multiple reflection of the sound should be occurred in such a way that we can get the sound, and the reverberation should be quite proper. It means when we talk, the reflections of the sound should be up to 1 to 2 seconds. It should be minimized, quite proper, or it should be minimized. There should be no concentration of sound in any part of the hall. Generally, what happened, our arrangement of the sound in such a way that sometimes we are putting the sound box in a such a direction, the maximum sound should be concentrated at that direction, and another side it is quite be low. So it should not be that. The sound should be no concentration of sound in any part of the hall. It should be equally distributed in the hall. Boundaries should be soundproof. Include extraneous void. Extraneous noise. What happens generally? Boundaries should be soundproof. Means generally what happens? At the surface of the wall, there in many times reflecting surface is there. More smoothness is there. So to avoid that one, soundproof should be there. Means it is arranged in such a way that they have be overlap, or we can say that the if their walls are there, it should be coated with, or coated, or you can say that leather or something is they're used to absorb the sound which is incident on the walls, or minimize the reflection. Like in auditorium, sometimes you can see that in cinema halls, generally there is some cushions are there, or sometimes some clothes are there, so that they can be absorb the loud sound from the walls, which reduce the sound from the reflection from the walls. And there should be no extraneous noise. Extraneous noise means the noise which is created by the outside. Okay, that should be reduced. Second thing, there should no echelon effect. Generally, echelon effect is occurred due to the some decorated material which are putted in the hall, or sometimes in theater. It can be create this noise due to the air. Sometimes some echelon effect is occurred due to the some variation. There should no resonance within the building. Means when we are talking, the sound should be reflected much more intense. That is resonance occurs. Resonance means enhancement of the amplitude of the sound, and it should be reduced. Okay, there should be no resonance in the. Some definitions, part of the definitions are used in the last article, that is the reverberation. Some definitions are there. Reverberation means what? The persistence of or prolongation of sound in the hall. Even though sound source is stopped, means what? When I am going to talk and I am stopped, still my sound is reflected in the hall, and it should be prolonged sometime due to the multiple reflection. But this prolongation of the sound from the walls, ceiling, floor of the room or the hall is called as the reverberation. When I am going to talk and stop, still my sound is reflected multiple times through the walls, ceilings, floors, rooms, halls, and therefore it is called as the reverberation. Okay, the time taken for the sound to fall below the minimum audibility measured from the instant when the source stops emitting. Time of reverberation means what? When I am going to stop my words, at the time due to the reflection, the intensity declined, but it is below the audibility, and to reach up to the below audibility, the time is taken. That time is called as the time of reverberation. What is reverberation? Persistence or prolongation of sound in the hall due to what? Reflection. Okay, the prolonged reflection of the sound. Okay, is called as the reverberation. And the time required to decline that sound up to minimum audibility or below the minimum audibility, that time is called as the time of reverberation. Time of reverberation is very important. It is sometimes it required the sound decay below the 60 dB from the initial level. Then this time, the generally what reverberation time is, the time required to decay to 60 dB. dB means decibel, from its initial level. Then that time is called as the reverberation time. Means below 60 dB we are unable to listen. Sabine found that the time of reverberation depends on the size of the hall, loudness, sound, kind of music, sound or music or sound. Okay, generally it is very simple. Sabine's formula gives that it depends on the size of the hall, area of the hall, sometimes intensity of the sound, music. Okay, because generally according to sound intensity and other thing, it is absorbed by the materials which are available in the hall. Acoustically good auditorium or the hall where the time of reverberation is negligibly small, means minimized. In case of the speech, series notes are produced in the hall. It's okay. But each one had its own intensity. The rate of decreasing intensity of impulse should be such as to allow others confusion. Generally what happened when we are going to deliver talk in the hall, generally we are talking different modes. Sometimes we are talking very quickly, sometimes we are talking very politely, sometimes we are loudly. So the intensity is different, and according to that the sound should be reach to the everyone with minimum reverberation. Okay, the time of reverberation should be negligibly small, very small. Okay, it is found that generally when we are talking with the frequency of 512 hertz, means 512 hertz, the time of reverberation should be in the range of 1 to 1.5 second, means reverberation time should be very small, that is 1 to 1.5 seconds. Okay, like that one. And it depends on, to minimize the reverberation time, we can use the anti-reverberation materials like porous tiles, asbestos, which can reduce the reverberation time. Hello. Now today we want to discuss on the lecture number 2, that is Sabine's formula, which is very important regarding the acoustic of building. Already we discussed on the some fundamental things regarding acoustic of building. In last lecture we discussed on the syllabus of unit number 1, paper number 3, applied physics, and we go through the fundamental things of the acoustic of building, like definition of reverberation, reverberation time, features for the good auditorium, like this. Now Sabine's formula. Professor Wallace C. Sabine of Howard University investigated architectural acoustics scientifically. Particularly with reference to the reverberation time, he deduced various experimentally the reverberation time, which is directly proportional to the volume of the hall and inversely proportional to the effective absorption surface area of the wall and the material inside the hall. W.C. Sabine found that when he performed a different experiment, the reverberation time depends on the volume of the hall. Second thing, he got the information that it is directly proportional to the volume of the hall and inversely proportional to the area, surface area, which absorb the sound, area of the walls, area of the materials inside the hall. So generally the reverberation time inversely proportional to the area and absorbing surface area of the walls and the material inside the hall. And therefore we can write here T, that is reverberation time, which gives us the value as T directly proportional to the V and inversely proportional to the absorption coefficient of the surface area which is available due to the walls and the materials inside the hall. Okay. Now V the wall of the volume of the hall and A is the absorption coefficient of the surface. Yes. If the volume is measured in terms of the cubic feet and the cubic area in square feet, then the experimentally obtained values of the constant of proportionality according to Sabine is 0.05. Okay. What is the proportionality constant, or we can say that the proportion we get in the exam in this formula is 0.05. Generally when you go through the reference book, already I mentioned SP and other books are there, so if you go through that one you can get that the how we can derive the Sabine's formula, and in that we can get the value of that constant is 0.05. it is quite lengthy, or it is long derivation. Okay, so go through that one. If there are the different things are available in the hall and their absorption coefficients are A1, A2, A3 and A4, and then the surface areas which are available in the hall are S1, S2, S3, S4. S1, S2, S3 may be the some chairs, fans, many things are there. According to the available materials inside the hall, the S1, S2, S3, S4 varies. So we can write for different absorbing surface areas, T is equal to 0.05 V divided by A1 S1 plus A2 S2 and so on. Means sum of the product of the absorption coefficient and the surface area of that material. Okay. And when we are going to reduce this equation, we can write this as T is equal to 0.1610 V divided by summation of AS. See, sometimes this may be changed in some reference book. It may be T is equal to 0.158 V divided by summation AS. Or the fraction of changes may be occurred according to literature. So you should refer the reference book. I recommend you the reference book like SP, which is mentioned by the Mumbai University. So go through that one. And it may be possible that there is a T is equal to 0.158 V divided by summation AS. Okay. And this T depends on the volume of the hull and product of the product of the absorbing surface area and their absorption coefficient of that material. Determination of the absorption coefficient. First of all, how to find out the absorption coefficient? To find out the absorption coefficient, generally what is the absorption coefficient? The absorption coefficient is the ratio of the energy absorbed, sound energy absorbed by the surface to that total incident sound energy of the surface. Generally, there are three types of coefficient. One is the absorption coefficient, second the reflection coefficient, and third is the transmission coefficient. Remember that. Generally, there are the three coefficients. One is the absorption, reflection, and transmission coefficient. Okay. And addition of this is 1. Remember that. Generally, when we are studying about the black body, you can get the idea about that one. Okay. Absorption, reflection, and transmission coefficient. Okay. So what is the definition of absorption coefficient? It is the sound energy incident on the surface divided by sound energy absorbed by the surface. Okay. Means amount of energy incident on the material. Amount of energy incident on the material. Then some of the amount of energy is absorbed, some of the amount of energy reflected, some of the amount of energy sometimes transmitted. It depends on the material to material, okay, according to the type of energy as well as this. Here the amount of energy is absorbed, we want to know that. Okay, this is very important, ratio of the sound. See, here is the there is a mistake in the formula. The sound energy incident on the surface divided by sound energy absorbed by the surface, it's reverse. Okay, remember that, this is the wrong one. It should be sound energy absorbed by the surface to the sound energy incident on the surface. This is my mistake. Sorry for that. So the standard unit of the absorption is the unit area of the open window. All sound falling on the open window pass through it, and the rate of sound energy absorbed by the certain area of the surface. So that the sometimes we want to count the window of the same area. So according to Sabine's formula, if we study about the without any absorption material and with absorption material, we can get the T1 and T2 with the reverberation times. And according to this, we can get this 1 by T1 is equal to A divided by 0.15161 V AS divided by 0.161 V. And when we are adding some materials and when at that time we study the reverberation time, and according to that, we can get the summation of AS. AS means when we are considering about the hull, and addition to that, when we are adding some material, then the reverberation time change, and therefore we can write here two materials, means hull, and addition to that, some materials which are we are taking in the hull. And according to that, when we are taking the difference between this, it gives the A1 S1 divided by 0.161 V, and we can get the value of that material, absorption coefficient of that material, A1 is equal to 0.161 V divided by A1 S1, and in bracket 1 by T1 minus 1 by T2, where T1 and T2 are the reverberation times. These are the some materials having the absorption coefficients, just like glass, marble, wooden floor, carpets, cushions, bricks wall. Generally, we feel that it may be not possible that every material should be absorb the sound, but there is a some materials are there which absorb the sound in this range. Okay. Next, acoustic of buildings. Acoustic of buildings deals with the design and construction of hall or the auditorium, or you can say that a music hall, concert, or different things. Okay. And then poor due to the distribution of the intensity is not uniform and different frequency of the sound interfere at the some points and reduce the quality. Generally what happens when we are not considering about the reflection of the sound or the arrangement of this auditorium hall, then there is a distribution of intensity of sound is not uniform. It is non-uniform, therefore it can possible that see that this people arrange in such a way that the sound should be listen up to reach up to the everyone. Okay, to get the good acoustical building, factors to be considered like a reverberation time, focusing and interference, echoes, echelon effect, resonance, extraneous noise. Means these are the some factors which affect the good quality of sound. So what is that factors? Reverberation time, focusing of the sound and interference, echoes and echelon effect, resonance and extraneous noise. Remember that these are the factors affecting the acoustic of building. Factors affecting on the acoustic of building, we are going in detail about that. Reverberation. First, reverberation is the time of reverberation for the hall, neither be too large nor too small. Therefore, it is remember that in the range of 1 to 2 seconds. Okay. The preferred value of the time of reverberation is called as the optimum reverberation time. And to get that reverberation time, we have the formula T is equal to 0.161 V divided by A. So you remember that I already mentioned that you should be go through this number 0.161 V by A or 0.158 V by A. Okay. Sometimes the number should be vary. Okay. Then reverberation time can be controlled by the providing the windows and ventilators to make the value of time of reverberation optimum, using the heavy curtains with the folds to adjust the reverberation time. We can control this reverberation time by using the curtains, folds, ventilators in the windows. Okay. And also we can provide the acoustic tiles. New tiles are there. So by providing the acoustic tiles and also covering the floor and carpets, remember with carpets. So generally in the PVR you can go through the movies, when you are go through the cinema halls, you can find that on the floor they use the red color carpets. Okay, on the wall also they can cover with the some carpets. Okay. And by full capacity of audience, generally according to capacity of the audience, audience and chairs, according to the their arrangement, we can control the time of reverberation. Adequate loudness. Adequate loudness. Sufficiently loudness is very in every portion of the hall is important. Okay. And to loudness may be increased by the use of large sounding boards behind the speaker will help to increase the loudness. Means we use the large sounding boards behind the speaker. Behind the speaker we should use this type of boards, and so that the sound should be increased. Second thing, low ceiling will be help in reflecting the sound energy towards the audience. Generally now you can see that in the cinema halls they are using the AC, and therefore they are the ceiling hall ceilings or the fans are less number, so that there is a reflecting sound everywhere in the audience. Okay. Third, focusing of the sound. Generally focusing of sound is necessary for the poor hall. In the generally acoustically poor hall, there is a need of the silence in everywhere, otherwise sound is not distributed. Generally sound is not distributed, or it is a bad distribution of the intensity of sound is occur when the hall is acoustically poor. So to get the uniform distribution of sound in the hall, the ceiling should be low. Second thing, parabolic reflectors will be help to focus the sound. See, in the earlier we can see that is earlier in the diagram there was the arrangement like a parabolic reflectors, and curved surface should be covered with the absorbing materials. Curved surface should be covered with the absorbing materials like a carpet we can use. Absence of echoes. Echoes is heard when the direct and reflected sound waves coming from the same source and reach the listener with the time interval of 1 to 15 seconds. Means when we are discussing on the sound, and the listener sound and reflection sound, if they are come together in the interval of time of 1 to 15 second, means 1 divided by 15 second, means nearly 0.06 like second, in that case the echoes are occur. This lead to confusion of listener. Generally echoes are there, the overlapping of the syllabi, overlapping of the sound, and therefore we are unable to distinguish between the earlier statement and later statement. The echoes are reduced by the long distance walls and high ceilings with very good absorbing materials. Means when we are considering about that, the wall should be long, okay. It should be not be in such a way that the sound should be reflected in a range of that 1 divided by 15 seconds, okay. Second, echelon effect. The effect is the important factor affecting the acoustic of building. This effect is the production of the musical sound of the definite frequency due to the reflection of sound from the various structures such as railings, stairs. This occurs due to the successive echoes from these regular structures and reaching in the listener. The echelon effect can be overcome by spreading carpet over the steps. Generally what happens when we are coming in the hall, our shoes make the noise. Sometimes the sound is created by the another railing, stairs and other things. So to avoid that one, we should use the carpet. We spreading the carpet in the cinema hall so that sound should be minimized. Echelon effect should be minimized. And also making the spacing in the railing irregular or railing ceiling, echelon effect can be minimized. Last one, there is extraneous noise and the sound isolation. Noise is an unwanted sound. The noise may be due to the high frequency of sound or intensity or due to the both. The noise produces a displeasing effect on the air. These are the three types of noise which are troublesome. That is airborne, structure-borne, inside noise. Okay. The prevention of transmission of noise inside and outside the hall is known as the sound isolation or also the soundproofing.
Now I acknowledge myself to the I am very thankful to the principal J. Thakur sir, under whose motivation we try to develop this ICT teaching tool, and my colleagues Dr. Paresh Gaikar and Ms. Ankita Angre, who helped me a lot for prepare this presentation and this topic. I am here thanks to all, and I use the study material as the references, textbook of FIBAC and some diagrams and other things take from the internet.